A link has been posted to your Facebook feed. The 2018 Lincoln Navigator is a rolling condo with best zero-in class passenger space and 3 rows of passenger/cargo room. Based on the Ford F-150 body-on-frame chassis, its skin is all aluminum. Photo: Henry Payne/The Detroit News. By photo: The Lincoln Navigator is a rolling condo, big enough to comfortably seat 6 and sleep 4. With lush interior trimmings, Wi-Fi connectivity, and 30-way seats that make Barca loungers feel like lawn chairs, it shames most second homes. I have one criticism: where's the fridge? An icebox is about the only feature that is missing from this 181/2-foot long, 61/2-foot high, $95,000 masterpiece of luxury. It needs to be as Lincoln charts its premium comeback. It needs home runs like the Navigator to navigate the treacherous shores of six-figure luxury. An impressive navy of hulking battleships sail these waters, including the Cadillac Escalade, Land Rover HSR, Mercedes GLS, and Infiniti QX80. Lincoln does not shy from the fight. It brings the big guns. One big power from the same twin-turbo, 3.5-liter V6 engine that beats at the heart of the Ford F-150 Raptor, the baddest truck ever built. Stomp the Navi's gas, and it roars like King Kong at dinner time. Call it the Lincoln Raptor. Two biggest towing capacity, 8,700 pounds, in its class, courtesy of the same bones as the F-Series, the most capable pickup hauler on the planet. Three biggest heads-up display. 4 biggest seating capacity. 5 biggest moonroof. 0.6. Biggest fuel economy numbers thanks to that turbocharged 6 and Lincoln's first application of a 10-speed tranny, co-engineered with Ford and GM, that drives other rear-wheel drive performance powerhouses like the Camaro ZL1 and Raptor. But if you think all this brawn makes the Navigator look like a sumo wrestler on steroids, you'd be wrong. Because the remarkable thing about this land yacht is how elegant it is from stem to stern. The grille is 10 stories high, but modeled after the same Jaguar-esque sculpture that first graced the Lincoln Continental and MKZ sedans. It's a piece of art, replacing the split-wing grille that always looked awkward on big utes like wings on a rhino, with little Lincoln logos knitted into a honeycomb pattern. Anchored by a centered, giant Lincoln logo, the grille begins a theatrical welcome embrace, it's called when you approach the big ute. The logo glows, lighting a path from the LEDs in the headlights, to the lighted door handles, and finally, Lincoln's signature, horizontal rear lights. Big, illuminated running boards unfold from beneath the car to meet you. To complete the introduction, the mirrors sport LED lights that project the Lincoln logo on the pavement, think of it as a welcome mat. It's a dazzling display that stopped passersby in their tracks one night in the lot where I parked. It's the best show this side of the Tesla Model X's automatic driver system and Falcon Wing doors. I pined for the original Navigator concept that dropped jaws at the 2016 New York Auto Show with its own gullwing doors and cascading, fold-out, three-tier steps. Given that Tesla's complicated Falcon doors delayed production almost 2 years, it's probably best that Navigator left the gullwings in the attic.